Namaskar students, I am here with the next topic of the life process, that is respiration. We have discussed nutrition in organism in the last section. The food material is taken in during process of nutrition is used in cells to provide energy for various life processes. This is done through the process of respiration. Let's define respiration. A process in living organisms involving the production of energy, typically with the intake of oxygen and the release of carbon dioxide from the oxidation of complex organic substances. It can be represented by following equation, that is the glucose with the help of oxygen, they are producing carbon dioxide, water and energy in the form of ATP. In our previous classes, and we all are known about it here also, about the ATP. ATP is a molecule that helps in the production of energy, or I can say the energy is produced in the form of ATP and stored also in the form of ATP in our cell. Let's know more about ATP. Now, ATP or adenosine triphosphate is an organic compound that provides energy to drive many processes in living cells. Example, you can take like a muscle contraction, nerve impulse propagation, chemical synthesis, digestion, etc., etc., etc. Because it is found in all forms of life, it is called, also called the energy currency of cell. Okay, let's know more about the ATP. Now, ATP is made up of nitrogenous base, adenine, a sugar ribose, and three phosphate groups. Okay, now where it is produced? Okay. Now, ATP synthesis happens in the chloroplast and mitochondria. In plant, it is in chloroplast, and in the animals, it is in mitochondria. Let's see a quick look how it is formed. Okay. Now, an ATP has three parts. The first part, you can see, it is adenine. This is a nitrogenous base. Second part is ribose, a sugar. And the third part is phosphate group. Okay. The adenine and this ribose part together called adenosine. Okay. The three phosphate linked to the ribose in a chain are called triphosphate. Adenosine together with ribose and this triphosphate is called ATP or adenosine triphosphate. Okay, the wavy lines you can see over here represents high energy bonds. Okay, breaking the first high energy bond that you can see over here that releases the through the process of hydrolysis, actually it occurs. The ATP releases energy and a free phosphate. This energy is then used in cellular activities. Adenosine with only two phosphate is now called ADP or adenosine diphosphate. Energy that is produced by the breakdown of food is then used to change ADP once again into ATP. The energy stored in ATP is transferred and released whenever required for cellular activities. Hope you have understood the production and the structure of ATP. Now, the process of respiration. In humans and most other animals, the process of respiration completes in the following four major steps. What is the first one? This is the breathing. It is a physical process in which the atmospheric air is taken in and forced out of lungs. The second step is gaseous transport to tissues. The oxygen inhaled by breathing is absorbed by the blood in the lungs. The third step, tissue respiration. The arteries terminate into capillaries which deliver the oxygen to the body cell. And the fourth and most important is the cellular respiration. It involves release of energy by oxidation of food in the cell and conversion of the energy released into usable forms such as ATP. Now this, what is this cellular respiration? Cellular respiration is a chemical process that happens in cells. In prokaryotes, it happens in the cell membrane, and in eukaryotes, it happens mostly in the mitochondria. Now, types of cellular respiration. Depending upon oxygen is utilized or not, respiration or cellular respiration can be divided into two types. The first one, aerobic respiration. Second one, anaerobic respiration. The difference between this aerobic and anaerobic respiration we have already read in our previous classes, but then also here also it is very important, we must know about it. Okay, so aerobic respiration takes place in the presence of free oxygen, just opposite. Anaerobic respiration takes place in the absence of free oxygen. In aerobic respiration, complete oxidation of glucose takes place. In anaerobic respiration, the glucose molecule is incompletely broken down. The end product of aerobic respiration are carbon dioxide, water, and lots of energy. But the end product of anaerobic respiration are ethyl alcohol in each cell or lactic acid in human muscle cell, carbon dioxide and a little energy. The first step of aerobic respiration takes place in cytoplasm, while the next step takes place in mitochondria. The complete anaerobic respiration occurs in cytoplasm. It takes place in lower organisms like yeast and muscles of man, and aerobic respiration takes place in all higher organisms. The differences we will discuss at the end. I will give you. You please note down. Before that, let's see the formula or the equation of aerobic and anaerobic respiration. You can see over here, the glucose in the presence of oxygen producing carbon dioxide, water and 36 ATP. And if you are talking about anaerobic respiration, you can see glucose is broken down in the absence of oxygen to produce alcohol, and carbon dioxide is being released. And another situation you can see that when there is a lack of oxygen, then the glucose is broken down into lactic acid and energy is released. Now when it happens, now we know about it that when we do a vigorous exercise or we do this heavy physical work, that time when our body don't get enough oxygen to produce energy, or I can say that lots of energy is required at that time and that cannot be produced in the cell, our cell starts producing energy by anaerobic respiration, but that time what forms? Lactic acid, and energy is being released at that time. Now we will discuss about mechanism of respiration. Now a respiration occurs in two steps. First one is the glycolysis and second one Krebs cycle. Though in your NCERT book, this names are not mentioned. In a higher class, you will read about it in details. But for your knowledge, just I have put this terms over here. Okay, let's see the glycolysis. Now, what is this? Now, glycolysis, it is the first step of respiration, which is common to both aerobic and anaerobic modes of respiration. It occurs in cytoplasm. In this process, glucose, a 6-carbon molecule, break down into 2 molecules of pyruvate, which is a 3-carbon molecule. In the next step, that is the Krebs cycle, it takes place in mitochondria. The pyruvate may be converted into ethanol and carbon dioxide in the absence of oxygen and called anaerobic respiration that we have just discussed. This process takes place in yeast during fermentation. The breakdown of pyruvate using oxygen is called aerobic respiration, which releases carbon dioxide and water. Sometimes when there is a lack of oxygen in our muscle cells, pyruvate is converted into lactic acid. Here is a complete pathway has been shown over here. It is very important and asked in the exams. Please go through it. Whatever I have discussed, it is given in this diagram. You have to note down this. As I said, it is one of the important questions asked in the exam. Okay, with this we come to an end of my first video on the topic respiration. In the next video, I will discuss further on the same topic, respiration. Namaste.